Stacking is a feature available on select Cisco small business switches. To understand this feature and its benefits, let's take a look at some basic stacking concepts and terms. First, let's define what a stack is. A stack is a network solution composed of two or more stackable switches. Switches that are a part of a stack behave as one single device. As a result, a stacking solution shows the characteristics and functionality of a single switch, while having an increased number of ports. This allows users to expand their network capacity without the hassle of managing multiple devices. Additionally, switches can be added or removed from the stack as needed without affecting the overall operation of the stack. Depending on its topology, a stack can continue to transfer data even if a link or unit within the stack fails. This makes stacking an effective, flexible, and scalable solution to expand network capacity. Now that we have a general understanding of what a stack is and why you would want to consider a stack for your network, let's go over some basic stacking terms that you should know before setting one up. First, a stack has a master or commander. The master is the switch in the stack that handles the configuration for the entire stack. When you want to manage your stack, the master unit is the device that you connect to in order to make changes. The master also handles other important stack functions, such as detecting when switches enter or leave the stack, and upgrading outdated switches. The backup is a switch that will become the new master if the original master goes offline. In this way, a backup helps maintain the resiliency of the stack. A slave or member serves as an additional unit within the stack. Unlike the master and the backup units, the slave does not serve an additional function within the stack, other than to increase port capacity. As a result, if the master and the backup units fail, the stack will become disabled. Finally, a stack port is a port on the switch that is used to communicate with other switches in the stack. Depending on the model, a switch can have either pre-configured or user-defined stack ports. Now that we've gone over these basic stacking concepts and terms, you've hopefully gained a better understanding of what a stack is and how one would fit into your network. For more information about stacking, click on the article below or visit the Cisco Small Business Support Community for further assistance. Thanks for watching!